This is all my sea glass that I collected at the beach. Well, it's not all of it. This is just some sea glass that I've collected over a short period of time and brought home. To me, it's like a big puzzle. You dump it out on the table, and then you put it together, and you look at all the different pieces and the various colors that you've collected. There's so many little bits and pieces, and some are smoother than the others. So I took all the colors and separated them first. As I started to get this together, I thought I would try to make leaves or a trunk, and that didn't turn out very well. And I wasn't especially happy with the green coming down. There wasn't enough, actually. So I kept playing with it. I knew eventually I'd be able to put something together here, so I just kept playing. So I found this little rock. Butterflies are getting me. Found this little rock, and I called it a dot rock because it's got a dot right in the middle of it. So that's pretty cool. So if you find any dot rocks, you can let me know. Cute little fella. There's a yellow piece of dishware. There's all kinds of dishware. Dishware all scattered around the table. This had a design in it. This piece here. Oh, I just found a number 10 right there. Huh, guess I had more numbers than I thought. There's number 2 there. Guess those ones were hidden. Anyway, it was fun collecting this.
I just wanted to take a moment to actually come in closer and look at all the various shapes and sizes and colors. Pretty amazing when you can actually slow down and look at each individual piece and turn it over in the palm of your hand and think, yeah, that's pretty neat. So what do I do with all my sea glass? Some I store in jars, and every once in a while we'll have a bunch of people in and we'll take the sea glass, spread it out on the table, and just make whatever comes to mind. You never know what you're going to make. There's all kinds of people that like to buy sea glass. However, I don't sell any of mine. If I don't use it, I take it back to the shore and dump it in the water so somebody else can find it. I keep a few bottles around the house just to play with and have some fun. Some people use it for jewelry, and some people use it to make pictures and frame them and hang them on their walls in their house. There's all kinds of uses for sea glass.
That brown thing there, it seems to me like it's a piece of pottery, but I'm not really sure. This piece here was kind of interesting. That seemed like it was the corner to something. You set it down this way and have it come up. There's that little piece there. There's the inside. Like it might have been part of a bowl or a vase or something.
This little white piece in here might have been a teacup.
There's a little piece of iron with a hole through the middle. And I think I found a rock that had the same kind of thing. There's a hole that goes right through it.
Because I don't see those too often. Mama Robin is flying back and forth. She doesn't like me being here. So I'm going to put that back over with these little treasures. Just a couple more of that little pieces I found.
I'm always bringing home bits of rope because you can always use them for something, even if it's just to play with.
When you stand back and take a look, I found I wasn't all that excited about what I did, so I decided to change it up a bit. I didn't like the way I did that, so I took the leaves off, scattered them through the top of the flower, and then put the base on. I was rather pleased with that. But anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Hope to see you again real soon. Bye-bye for now.